This video shows you how to retrieve extended diagnostic error codes from your saw. Though the job site saw uses a bypass switch rather than a bypass key, the procedure is the same for all the saws. Status codes show typical status conditions for your saw. However, your saw may experience an error state, which prevents you from starting the saw or causes the saw to shut down automatically. If so, you can pull an extended error code or codes so that SawStop Service can determine the problem and help you with a solution. An error code is present when anything other than a solid green LED displays after the saw initializes. Normal behavior when you switch on power is that a solid green LED is accompanied by a flashing red LED while the system initializes. The solid green LED alone means the saw is ready and there are no system errors. However, in this example, after the power is switched on and the saw initializes, the flashing red LED indicates there is an error present. If you are not able to determine the error code from the status code's label on the saw, or from the information in the owner's manual, use the following procedure. Switch on power. After initialization, the flashing red LED indicates an error is present. Make sure the bypass key is fully inserted in the switch box. Turn the bypass key 90 degrees clockwise and hold the key in this position. The LEDs begin to flash to indicate the error code sequence. The code sequence is very simple, but it can be a little tricky to follow the first time you see it. This illustration slows things down and shows how the basic scheme works. After you turn and hold the bypass key, both LEDs will turn off and then turn on for a moment. The green LED then flashes a certain number of times, in this case just one time. The red LED then flashes a little more quickly, a certain number of times, in this case twice. Both LEDs then flash on once again for a moment, and the sequence repeats. Here is the cycle again at actual speed. As long as you are holding the key, the code sequence will repeat. In this example, there is one green flash and two red flashes, which is the error code 1, 2, or 12. This particular code means the cartridge key was not in the locked position. So that's it for the code sequence. Just count the flashes. Once you have the error code, contact SawStop Service. The service team can tell you what the error code means and how to resolve the associated issue. And it's best to call while you're at the saw so service can actively troubleshoot with you. It's possible there is more than one error. Here's how you can confirm. Turn and hold the bypass key, as you did previously. At any point after the first code sequence is complete and begins repeating, release the key and then immediately turn and hold the key again. If there is another error code, it will display. If not, the original error code will continue repeating. In this example, there is another error code, 11, indicating a spacing error between the blade and the pawl. If your saw shuts down due to an error, leave the start-stop paddle in the on position while you pull extended diagnostics. The paddle must be in the on position to show the proper diagnostic code. For the job site saw, the procedure is the same, except that you use the bypass switch rather than a bypass key. You have learned how to pull extended error codes. Thanks for watching. If you need a bypass key, you can purchase at our store on SawStop.com. If you have further questions, contact SawStop Service.